There's uncertainty tonight for millions of Australians waiting for the COVID vaccine, with the Prime Minister taking to social media to explain why he's dumped key targets for the rollout timeline. It comes as a new report warns international travel could be off the agenda for longer than we thought.
The rollout rolls on, with 1,000 more GPs mobilised this week.
Didn't feel a thing.
But the Prime Minister is feeling the pressure, abandoning vaccine targets and turning to social media to explain the change in strategy.
Rather than set targets that can get knocked about by every to and fro of international supply chains and other disruptions that can occur, we're just getting on with it.
But speed is of the essence.
To have the economic recovery proceed with confidence, we need a clear rollout plan with timelines and targets.
I don't want to see our citizens left behind because the rest of the world starts trading with each other, starts travelling.
And a new report by Deloitte Access Economics has warned international travel for Australians won't return to pre-pandemic levels until 2024. That's based on the assumption virus numbers remain low as the vaccine rollout ramps up.
While the October deadline for all Australians to receive their first jab is long gone, there is still a date in the calendar for some.
Our aim to continue on with our priority populations, getting them vaccinated by the middle of the year, is essentially unchanged.
As we're told to get on with it, there's a growing hesitancy after AstraZeneca was linked to rare blood clots.
We did have a few cancellations, especially for those under 50.
Pfizer was named as the preferred vaccine for people in this age group. The scramble on to build up the stockpile.
Look at what's going on still overseas. That could still happen if we don't get our population vaccinated.
Back on social media, the Prime Minister finished his update with an admission there's still a long road ahead.
One of the things about COVID is it writes its own rules. You don't get to set the agenda.
Fiona Willen, Nine News.